that if people hear a lie long enough, people believe it, that people have lied on me. I'm a black American and I'm proud of it, and I'm honored of it. The bleach skin rumor, which is a rumor, I don't bleach my skin. I'm not gay.
The assistant comes in like, you guys can have a seat. So we sit down. He comes in. He's tall. Standing there. Two beautiful women walk in. He kisses one. Like, full on. It's a moment. It ain't like no peck. It's like a real situation.
Black girl, white girl.
They look Brazilian. So I'm like, wow. He's a G.
Shauna Mongatal was a 23-year-old receptionist when she first met Michael.
He is a normal man. He's a red-blooded man. He's very flirtatious. He loves women.
1988, and Michael was at the height of his fame. I had gone to New York to see him on his Bad Tour. He performed a concert at Madison Square Garden. And by some stroke of luck, I ended up in his hotel room after the show at this after party that he was throwing. And Michael was there. And eventually Michael came over and introduced himself to me. He reached out his hand to shake my hand, and I shook his hand. And then when I tried to let go of his hand, he kept holding on to my hand. And then he slid his hand all the way down mine. And from that moment on, I knew that there was more to Michael than met the eye. I knew he liked the ladies.
Wow.
Was Michael Jackson gay?
Absolutely not.
You say that with conviction.
He would always, like whenever we were, he would always kind of, he called it fishing.
Good fish! Whoa, whoa.
That's a good fish right there.
Called it fishing. He'd look around for all the hot girls.
Get some more fish right here. Get some more fish.
And he's, oh, that, turkle, turkle, that one's really hot. Oh, look, look, she's, oh, look how her hair just swirls. She's
so you don't think that was an act?
No.
What? That he was doing for me? Yeah. No, absolutely not.
Did he ever comment on young men?
No.
I don't think they fully got how much of a real man he was, coming from a different generation, a different conception, you know, of the way to be masculine.
And talking to L.A. Reid, and in talking to Teddy Riley, guys who spent a lot of time with him, they both told me stories about these women in the studio. Okay, I mean, it's an interesting thing. I was, you know, everyone has their perceptions of what Michael was about. But I tell you what, L.A. Reid is a guy I know very well. I know Teddy Riley very well. These are very straight guys. And they're telling me that Michael had fine-ass women in the studio hanging out with him. It's be around the turn of the century. So he goes to a party with Michael. Michael's asking him, where's Beyonce? Because he's never met Beyonce at this point. Because he wanted to see her. And he made a reference about her derriere. And he goes, I want to see the girl with the... He comes over and he introduced her to Beyonce. Then Michael sees a woman in the crowd and bring her over. Michael chats with her. Michael does not take her phone number. As any well-known star knows, you never take the phone number. Your man takes the phone number. So this guy ends up getting the number from Michael. So it's interesting that there's this whole narrative about Michael as a heterosexual male. Hanging out with guys I know who are very heterosexual male.
Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? So then I go and I find Mike. I'm like, Mike, what's up? What you doing here? Yeah. Thanks for coming. And then so I get him a booth. We go to the booth. We start chit-chatting. And so right there, he has his arm, bring that up so they can see his arm around me. But then you don't see the shot of him whispering in my ear. And right after the shot was taken, he whispers in my ear. He says, where's Beyonce?
Really? Really? Wow. Wow.
Came to the party to holler at Beyonce. This was before Jay-Z, though. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. He came to the party to holla at Beyonce, finds her, and dances with Beyonce mm-hmm. in the party.
Cool.
Yeah. Cool. Mike was smooth, Jack.
Hi.
Square, New York City. New York City, where people have come together at a time when we need everyone to come together here in Times Square. All brought together by this man in the blue shirt, the invincible one, Michael Jackson.
Michael chats with her. Michael does not take her phone number. As any well-known star knows, you never take the phone number. Your man takes the phone number.
We have wrote it down. The number.
I met him first in 77 when they were first signed to Epic Records and did a first project with Gamble and Huff called Going Places and work with them.
But Emilian, when you hear people make the allegations that he was behind closed doors a monster to children, your thoughts on that?
Well, the fact is right now is, you know, to convict a person when he's dead is like, okay, you know, he's not here to defend himself. So what can you say? But then my thoughts are, you know, I knew Michael as a different person. You know, so I never knew Michael like that or that side of Michael. He's a regular guy. He was chasing girls.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so, yeah, we knew him to do that.
He was the big girl chaser.
Never. Listen, Michael, when he spent time with Diana Ross with The Wiz, he always had this admiration for Diana Ross when he was young. And I think it got to a point where he really loved her and he really liked her, still to this day. And she was just this dream for him. And he had this ongoing, just a fascination for her. He loved her.
And I was dating Michael back then. I thought I was going to marry Michael.
Well, she knows that.
You know what I want to say? Michael is very much a man. And he was very loving. He was very caring.
Know what?
Because he lived on Sutton Place, and he was filming the Wiz movie, and I used to go over and spend the night, and I would do his laundry.
Wow.
And we would go down to the laundry together. So Michael is not what they are. He's very real, and he's very, and I've never spoke about that, but he's very just a regular kind of guy. Michael is a great kisser. I've kissed him. He's a great kisser. He's a great kisser.
Yeah,
and he's very, very affectionate.
Where did he kiss you at? In
did he kiss me at? Where do you want? Where do you think he kissed me?
Whoa!
Come on in, ease on down the road. I don't you carry nothing.
I love all the girls in the balcony. Well, Katharine Hepburn, who is a dear friend of mine, she told me I should, and I'm doing it for her, okay? And the girls in the balcony.
Guy, he was chasing girls.
We knew him to do that.
He was the big girl chaser.
Called it fishing. He'd look around for all the hot girls.
We're here for some good fish. Next up is easy.
But I can sit here under oath or any other way you want it, and I'm a staunch Catholic, I'll swear in the Bible, Michael is not gay, nor has he ever been gay. He's confided in me that certain women that he had relationships with, he wasn't public about any of it because, you know, you don't want the fans to think you're tied down. They don't have that shot of getting to you.
I went to his home, Neverland, and he pulled out all of the stops. He picked me up in a helicopter, and I got to the house, and he had a coach and buggy pick me up from the gate to his home.
Michael told me about being on the set of a movie, and one of the leading ladies invited him to her room to watch a movie, and I guess they were saying would be she jumped his bones.
I know some of the stars that Michael had been with. I'll take that to my grave.
Was he a pedophile?
No.
No, we don't believe so.
I don't believe so.
Not at all.
Being a father myself and being a man, men know men. He had the desires of women like we do.
In fact, they say he had at least two girlfriends, dispelling that other rumor.
We had a curtain in that covered the back seat. You couldn't see in the back seat. They talked back there and, you know.
So he's making out in the back seat?
Or chewing loud gum.
It sounds like you're chaperoning two teenagers on a date.
That was cute for us.
You want to be honest? There was a girl that I took from that party back home, and I couldn't stay there and do it. Actually, I saw Michael take a girl home from his own party, too.
But I heard him mention this idea of pornography. Well, he's correct. They found approximately 90 girly magazines in Michael Jackson's home. Playboy, Hustler, Penthouse. His fingerprints were on them. He had bought them. They never found any kiddie porn on computers or anywhere else, and I used that fact in my closing argument to explain why this guy is not a pedophile. So, a lot of things that the media picked up and gave you a surface impression about were not at all what they were made to seem.
I made a list of things. When I get angry enough, I write down what I want to say and what I want to talk about to set the record straight. Because you get to a point where you get tired of people lying. I get tired of situations like this, where people completely lie on me, and I'm sick of it.